Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. We were studying chapter number 2, that is chemical changes and reactions. As we know that the chemical changes or reactions are always accompanied by energy changes, which may be in the form of heat, light, electricity, sound and work etc. So in this video, today we'll study about the types of chemical reactions on the basis of energy change. On the basis of energy change, we have four types of reactions. These are exothermic reaction, endothermic reaction, photochemical reaction, and electrochemical reaction. First of all, we have exothermic reaction. During an exothermic reaction, heat is given out. So we can say that a chemical reaction which proceeds with the evolution of heat energy is called an exothermic reaction. And usually, heat is evolved when new bonds are formed. As energy is released during the exothermic reaction, so the container in which an exothermic change or exothermic reaction takes place will be warm. In general, the exothermic reaction is represented by writing the amount of heat evolved during the reaction with plus sign on the product side. For example, when carbon reacts with oxygen, 94.5 kilocalorie heat is evolved. So we can write the reaction as C plus O2 gives CO2 plus 94.5 kilocalories. Or it can be simply written as carbon means C plus O2 gives CO2 plus heat energy. Or it can also be written like C plus O2 gives CO2 plus Q kilojoules. Here Q represents the amount of heat evolved during the chemical reaction. The formation of water from hydrogen and oxygen is also an exothermic reaction. And during this reaction, 136 kilocalories of heat is evolved. So it can be represented by writing 2H2 plus O2 gives 2H2O plus 136 kilocalories. The next type of reaction is the endothermic reaction. During an endothermic reaction, the heat energy is taken in. So we can say that a chemical reaction which proceeds with the absorption of the heat energy is called an endothermic reaction. The heat absorbed during the chemical reaction is used for breaking of old bonds to make the new products. Generally, the endothermic reaction is represented by writing the amount of heat absorbed during the reaction on the product side with minus sign. For example, decomposition of calcium carbonate to form calcium oxide and carbon dioxide is endothermic reaction. So it can be represented by writing CaCO3 gives CaO plus CO2 minus heat energy. Then the formation of nitric oxide from nitrogen and oxygen is also an endothermic reaction. So it can be represented by writing N2 plus O2 gives 2NO minus Q kilojoules or minus heat energy. When carbon reacts with sulfur to form carbon disulfide, 22 kilocalories of heat is absorbed. So it can be represented by writing C plus 2S gives CS2 minus 22 kilocalories. Then the third type of reaction is photochemical reaction. A photochemical reaction is a reaction which proceeds with the absorption of light energy. For example, when the gaseous mixture of hydrogen and chlorine is exposed to sunlight, then only hydrogen chloride is formed. The process of photosynthesis in plants also takes place in the presence of sunlight. During photosynthesis, plants absorb sunlight to form glucose and oxygen from carbon dioxide and water. And ozone is formed from oxygen when UV rays fall on oxygen molecules. Then the fourth type is electrochemical reaction. As the name indicates, electrochemical reaction is a reaction which proceeds with the absorption of electrical energy. For example, the water dissociates into its constituent elements hydrogen and oxygen when electric current is passed through acidulated water. And when electric current is passed through sodium chloride, then the formation of sodium and chlorine takes place. Then moving on to the next topic. Whenever we burn anything, for example, if we burn a piece of paper, it produces heat and light. Burning of paper produces carbon dioxide also because when the paper burns, the carbon present in paper reacts with oxygen to form carbon dioxide. Hence, burning results in the liberation of heat and light along with the formation of an oxide. So we can define burning as a chemical change in which a combustible substance reacts with oxygen to produce new compounds called oxides along with the liberation of large amount of energy in the form of heat or light or both. Note here that combustion always takes place in the presence of oxygen. For example, when magnesium is burnt in the presence of oxygen, then it reacts with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. And during the burning of magnesium in the presence of oxygen, a lot of heat and light is also produced. And if we burn methane in presence of oxygen or air, it forms carbon dioxide and water along with the evolution of heat and light. There are two main conditions required for burning or combustion. First one is that the substance must be in the environment which supports combustion, means the substance should be present in oxygen or air. Then the second one is that the temperature of the substance must be above the ignition temperature. Ignition temperature is the minimum temperature at which any substance catches fire. It can also be defined as the temperature to which a substance must be raised before burning.